Hey everyone, Steve Patterson here from PhotoshopEssentials.com. In this video, I'll show you how to add a simple border around your photo with Photoshop. I'll be using Photoshop CC, but any recent version will work. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe and let's get started. Go ahead and open the image you want to place inside the border. I'll use this image that I downloaded from Adobe Stock. If we look in the Layers panel, we see the image on the background layer, and we see that the layer is currently locked. We need to unlock the layer so we can add other layers below it. To unlock it, in Photoshop CC, just click the lock icon. In CS6 and earlier, press and hold your Alt key on a Windows PC or the Option key on a Mac and double-click. This removes the lock icon and renames the layer Layer 0. To add more space around the image, we'll use Photoshop's Canvas Size command. Go up to the Image menu in the menu bar and choose Canvas Size. In the Canvas Size dialog box, make sure that the Relative option is checked. And in the Anchor grid, make sure the Center Square is selected. This will add the new space equally around the image. Then, enter the size you need for your border into the Width and Height fields. Now, keep in mind that the size you enter will be divided equally between both sides of the image, and this is true for both the width and the height. So if you need a 1/4-inch border, you'll need to set the width and height to 0.5 inches. For a 1-inch border, enter 2 inches. In other words, whatever size you need, enter twice that amount. In my case, I want a 1/2-inch border, so I'll set the width and height to twice that, or 1 inch. Then click OK to close the dialog box. And here we see the new canvas space around the image. The checkerboard pattern means that the space is currently filled with transparency, but we'll add color to it next. If you made a mistake and chose the wrong size for your border, you can undo it by going up to the Edit menu and choosing Undo Canvas Size. Then you'll want to reopen the Canvas Size dialog box by going back to the Image menu and choosing Canvas Size to try again. To fill the border with color, we'll use a solid color fill layer. In the Layers panel, click the New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon, then choose Solid Color from the list. In the Color Picker, I'll choose white for now, but I'll show you how to change the color in a moment. Click OK to close the color picker, and Photoshop temporarily fills the entire document with white, blocking the image from view. To fix that, back in the Layers panel, click and drag the fill layer below the image. And now the color from the fill layer appears only inside the border. If you want something other than white for your border, you can choose a different color by double-clicking on the fill layer's color swatch. This reopens the color picker where you can choose something different. And as you try different colors, you'll see a live preview of the new color around the image. So if I choose black instead of white, then my border instantly changes to black. Now you can choose any color you like from the color picker, or you can choose a color directly from the image. Just move your cursor into the image and click on a color. I'll choose a light gray from the window in the background. And again, the border instantly changes to the new color. To accept it, click OK to close the color picker. So now that we've added the main border, let's add a second, smaller border around the inside of the main one. And to do that, we'll use a layer effect. Back in the Layers panel, select the image on the top layer. Then click the Layer Styles icon, or the Effects icon, at the bottom, and choose Stroke from the list. In the Layer Style dialog box, I'll leave the stroke color set to black for now, and I'll make sure that the position of the stroke is set to inside. Then I'll increase the size of the stroke by dragging the size slider. As you drag, you'll see the stroke getting wider around the inside of the main border. If you don't want black as your stroke color, you can change it by clicking the color swatch. Then choose a different color from the color picker. Or, just like we did with the main border, you can choose a color directly from your image. I'll click on a color from the background. And the stroke instantly changes to the new color. When you're done, click OK to close the color picker. Finally, I'll finish off the effect by adjusting the size of the stroke to make it a bit smaller. For my image, a size of around 32 pixels should work. And then to accept it, I'll click OK to close the dialog box. And there we have it! That's how easy it is to add a border and even two borders around your image with Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please consider liking it, sharing it, and subscribing to my channel. Visit my website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, for more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from PhotoshopEssentials.com.